Yeah, Ryan Ford from Newstead, Victoria. And we've got the HDT Marlboro Panelvan here with a blown 454. And she's just a dirty old truck motor, just thrown together over the last few months for drag challenge. So mate Stork built the car for him, and about 3 months ago it was orange with windows in the side, so all the paintwork's all brand new. And it was supposed to get a 308 and a four speed, and then I slightly influenced him down this path and ruined him. So he'd had the car for a few years just with the 173 and just drove it around, and then we got the car about 6 months ago off him, and started tinkering with it, and then it all sort of went together in the last couple of months for drag challenge. So I finished it on Saturday and then got to tech on the Sunday. Brought my Camaro 2 years ago with a ProCharge big block and a Muncie in it, so the old four-speed didn't hold up to the drag racing very well. And that's a part and currently going together with a 515 Merlin, an Ultra Glide. So yeah, this, we really wanted to come back this year with a car, so we thrashed out so we'd at least have something to not be a spectator. It's got a just 671 on it. It's just a BDS blower. Pretty basic setup. It's twin 850s on it, which are old junk carbs. They're just hanging in there. The motor's just stock Silverado, late 90s Silverado 4-bolt motor with a 540 blower cam and some roller rockers. That's it. And then it's got a adamant ATS transmissions. He did a really good job on a glide for us. And yeah, so it shifts that hard. It's like a dog clutch in a boat. and he had a small block converter there that was supposed to be 2300, so that sort of flashes to about 35 with this combo. So that's all working great. And just got a 35 spine 9 inch in it, a strange center section. But yeah, the car could do with this 30 inch tire, it could do with a 411 in it to get it to 60 foot. It's pretty doughy out of the hole. But beautiful on the highway for this week, so we'll turn it up on at colder, try and hang the rods out of the old motor. Should be good. Well, yeah, the paint scheme is just made to look like it's been pulled out of a barn without going over the top with the sanding or anything like that. So yeah, pretty happy with the Pacina paint job. I spent hours chipping the front, drinking beers with a little square, and just sit there, drink beers, tap, 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 stone chip for hours. So I think we've got it looking pretty good. Still gonna do some more work on the paintwork to finish it off. We went 1190 yesterday, but with on 4 pound boost, so we're gonna pulley it up and put some smaller tires on it, and we should be able to get it into a 10 with this old engine. We were expecting about where we are for the amount of boost and tire we've got on it. I think by the end of the week, we should end up exactly where we thought this combo would be capable of without blowing its pieces. If we can get some 10 seconds out of it end of the week, I reckon we've got enough gear to do, we'll call that a success, I reckon. We just made a jet change and it dropped 3/10 on one jet change. So it's moving pretty fast with minor changes, the ETs. So I think water meth injection with some timing is gonna make a big difference. Well, it's great on the road, moves around on the tire a bit. But the response with people on the street is unbelievable. A swarm of people around the van at the supermarket, just cameras. So it's definitely a crowd pleaser. people love it.